गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे लेक्चर नंबर 8 अंडर मॉड्यूल 1 एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस, बट टुडे सब टॉपिक इज बेसिक्स ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इन द टुडेज क्लास लेट अस डिस्कस दिस 4 सब टॉपिक्स। व्हाट इज थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, what is meant by a system, then concept of work and heat, then laws of thermodynamics. Well, what is thermodynamics? Thermodynamics is a branch of science and sub branch of engineering which deals with heat and work interaction. When I say heat and work interaction, let me give an example. You are using a laptop. When you plug in for a charging of laptop, it draws electrical energy and does some work. When you use the laptop, you are doing some work, but over a period of time the system gets heated up. That means somewhere work is getting converted into heat. Another example, a cell phone. We recharge our cell phone every day, and when we try to communicate with someone and use it for a longer period of time, you feel it gets heated up. Because work is continuously done, that heat is also being produced. What I mean to say, when some work is done, it is converted into heat, or when the heat is being generated, it is utilized to convert into work. That means heat and work are interrelated with each other. That is thermodynamics. Then coming to the system. This is an example of a system. Anything that contains a specific matter within, that is known as system. For example, consider an arrangement of piston and gas, a closed cylinder in which some quantity of fluid, that is gas, is contained, and it is fitted with a piston. The pressure is exerted from the top, from the piston, over the gas fluid against the pressure of the fluid. This is the pressure of the fluid. This is the force of the piston that is balanced. And this dotted line of the system is known as boundary. Anything outside the boundary is called as surroundings. Anything inside the boundary is called matter. This whole together constitutes a system. That is known as thermodynamic system. And in this thermodynamic system, you have 3 types of system. One is closed system. What is closed system? In a closed thermodynamic system, energy transfer alone takes place but not the mass. Energy transfer alone takes place but not the mass. For example, in an IC engine, which I will explain here, with the help of this diagram, look at this. This is an engine. You might have seen engines in bikes, cars, scooters, every other mobile vehicle has an engine. And that makes use of the fuel, either petrol or diesel or gas. When that fuel is supplied into the engine, some amount of heat is generated. And that energy transfer takes place from the system, but not the mass. That is called as closed system. That means energy transfer alone. Energy transfer alone. Whereas the second type of system is open system. Open system. In this case, both energy as well as mass transfer takes place from the system. For example, an air compressor. When you want to refill the air into the tubes of your tires of your bicycle or even your bike, when you go to workshop, you might have seen that air compressor, where the air is being compressed inside the cylinder and air comes out of the cylinder with high pressure, both energy as well as mass transfer takes place. That is called as open system. So shall we write here both energy and mass transfer takes place. Then obviously what should be the third? Third system is isolated system. Isolated system. My dear students, let me give an example. Take a thermos flask. It maintains the hotness or coldness of the fluid, whatever that is filled in. Neither energy transfer nor mass transfer takes place. Neither energy nor mass. So that type of system is called as isolated system. That means no transfer, no energy and mass transfer takes place. So these are the three types of thermodynamic system. Then coming to the next subtopic, concept of work and heat. My dear students, hope all of you are familiar with the two-wheelers and four-wheelers. Some of you might be using also on your own. You might be driving bike or scooter or car. But have you ever thought how exactly an engine inside this automobile works? Today you will learn this. It's so beautiful and interesting. I have just made a layout of that automobile vehicle. Let's say this is the engine, very heart of the system. And here is the fuel tank. In case of two-wheeler, it is normally on the top side. In case of four-wheeler, normally it is at the bottom. When the fuel is drawn along with the air plus fuel, both, when it is drawn into the engine, what happens inside the engine? The piston moves inside the engine cylinder, and that chemical energy of the fuel is converted into heat energy. So what is produced here is heat energy. Heat energy is produced. And that heat energy is called as gases, and that high pressure gases will make the piston to move up and down. That is nothing but heat is converted into work. That heat is converted into work. Look at here. What is produced inside the cylinder? Heat energy. And it is converted into work. That is the concept of work and heat. Either work can be converted into heat, or heat can be converted into work. So this is an example. Of course, these two circles represent the wheels of an automobile, and here the two persons on the bike sits. This is a just layout. So here, heat into work interaction. This happens in many automobiles and engines. Let us take the reverse one. Here we understood how heat energy is converted into work. Now let us see how work can also be converted into heat energy. Let us look at this sketch. Any idea what this figure or image represents? Anybody? Yes, you are right. It is nothing but refrigerator. Here already it is written here, refrigeration, refrigerator. Even I am very sure every one of you may not be having an automobile vehicle, but most of you might be having a refrigerator at home. For what reason we use this refrigerator? To keep all perishable items inside, milk, vegetables, fruits, etc. But what exactly happens inside the refrigerator? That most of us may not be interested in knowing as a layman, but as
a technical students, now you should know what exactly happens inside the refrigeration. When you switch on the refrigerator, the liquid refrigerant moves here through the coils and takes away all the heat. This is the space inside the refrigerator where the temperature should be less temperature than the outside temperature, and that heat is taken away by the condenser. Here is the condenser. That means heat from the space is taken away and it is discharged outside, and less temperature is maintained inside, and that is the principle of refrigeration. But how does it work? Here we have a pump or compressor. This is a compressor, and we have condenser, we have a evaporator. So all these works using electrical energy, and that work is converted into heat. On the back side of the refrigerator, we experience that it is very hot. Inside it is very cold, but outside it is very hot. That is where work is converted into heat. Here heat is converted into work, and here work is converted into heat. So refrigeration is exactly opposite to that of the engine, but both relate to the same concept, that is conversion of either work into heat or heat into work. That is the third subtopic of work and heat. So note of this, I shall allow you for a minute, and then let us discuss last topic.